Hi, welcome to this question right here. So we're trying to state which of the following systems here is either one solution, no solution, or infinite number of solutions. So the idea is simple. You know what, if you can actually solve it in terms of y equals mx plus b, you're able to see everything. So let's go ahead and figure everything out here. So we have three systems right here, right? So let's take a look at the first one right here. It seems like if I solve the y here, it will be y equals to negative 3x and plus a 7. And this one over here will be y equals to negative 4x plus a 7, okay? It looks very identical, but if you actually take a look at the slope, it's going the same direction, but the steepness is slightly different. So having a different slope, but the same y-intercept is actually going to give you just one solution. Because if you go ahead and just kind of graph it on the side, it both starts at y equals 7. For example, that's a 7 right there. One of them kind of goes this direction, the other one kind of goes like this direction, okay? So their slope is slightly different, but even though they intersect the same y-intercept, they're only touching each other just one time. So for this one right here, it only has just one solution. So that's the answer for the first system. For the second system, sometimes you can actually tell if you do this question, if you do a lot of questions, but at the beginning, I would suggest just solve for y. So let's go ahead and just solve for y right there. I'm going to just solve the y there. You can actually work on the math from there. So what happened to negative 6, if you move over, divide by 2, it's negative 3x. And the 10 over here, just divide by 2, which is a 5. Okay? Over here, I got a y, and just divide by, move the 3x over, and then it's plus a 5. Okay? I move everything over, and I divide everything by 2 for the first equation. So that's what I have right there. Oh, take a look. It's the same. Well, if it's exactly the same formula, that means they overlap on top of each other. So that means they will have infinite number of solutions. So for this one, in the middle one, we have infinite number of solutions. Okay, that's our second answer here. For the last one, it's probably the one that says none, but let's take a look. How can you get a non-solution? So if I just solve the y right here, it will be y equals to, move the y over, I got x, move the 3 over, it's minus 3. This one over here, if I move the 3 over, it's going to do the work on the bottom. Move the 3 over here, 3x stays here, minus 6. Divide everything by the 3, you get yourself x minus 2. Okay? I think that is my 3 here. Am I doing this right? Yeah, 3, 1, that's a 2 right there, and that's a 3 right here. Okay? So what do we have here is this. We got a different slope. Okay? Sorry, a same slope, but with different y-intercept. So this line right here, it's actually better if you just draw it. The first line here is happens at negative 3 as a y-intercept. So if you go down 1, 2, 3, the slope is up 1 over 1, so it looks like something like this. Okay? But for the second equation, it happens at y equals negative 2, but with the same slope. So what happened is these two lines, they kind of go up at the same angle, same slope, but they both start at a different place. So what that means is, because they're going with each other parallel, they're never going to touch each other, okay? So that's why the answer for this will be just no answers, all right? So once again, you might want to solve the whole thing in terms of y equals mx plus b, and then you can see it better from there, okay? Thanks for watching.